When it comes to the case against Stephen Donziger, I have been hoping that someone in DC has been paying attention to this case and they're willing to speak up on his behalf, because what is being done to him is absolutely unjustifiable. And if what is done to him is allowed to stand, if the president of the United States doesn't intervene, then this just paves the way for more prosecution, more legalized harassment, the weaponization of the law against other individuals who choose to hold fossil fuel giants accountable when they ruin the planet. Now, the Stephen Donziger Twitter account tweeted out that 9 lawmakers, including AOC, demand Biden's DOJ take immediate action to release Stephen Donziger. Now, this is incredibly encouraging because members of the squad, along with some other lawmakers, have signed a joint statement to the Department of Justice, and they're calling on Merrick Garland and the president, more specifically, to drop this case, intervene, and stop his sentence. I mean, he's serving 6 months in jail. He was found guilty of contempt after Chevron went after him. And it's unacceptable, and it can't be allowed to stand, especially if it is the case that, you know, the Biden administration cares about climate change. And we know that they don't, but if he wants to at least hold up this appearance that he cares, then this is something that he has to address. So let's get to the letter, because the letter that they wrote was absolutely phenomenal. So they say, "We write to you with an urgent request that your office take immediate action regarding Stephen R. Donziger, a U.S. human rights lawyer who helped Ecuadorian victims of oil pollution obtain a historic judgment in Ecuadorian courts against Chevron. Mr. Donziger, who has no prior criminal record, has been a beloved and vaunted member of the environmental and human rights communities for decades. Mr. Donziger has done nothing but uphold the highest professional ethics in representing and protecting his clients, but has since been thrown in federal prison for petty contempt charges, a first in United States history. Mr. Donziger began serving a 6-month sentence for petty contempt of court at the Federal Correctional Institution in Danbury, Connecticut on October 27th of 2021, despite the many calls from the international legal community that his pretrial detention for over 800 days was a violation of international law. This case has shocked the worldwide community of environmental justice and human rights advocates and creates a distinct chilling effect on this type of advocacy going forward. 6 members of Congress wrote to your office in April of 2021 requesting a thorough review of the circumstances of Mr. Donziger's prosecution. In September of 2021, the same week Mr. Donziger was sentenced, the United Nations Working Group on Arbitrary Detention wrote a scathing opinion finding that Stephen Donziger's deprivation of liberty is a violation of international law and that the trial against him and the judges involved, specifically Federal District Court Judges Louis A. Kaplan and Loretta Preska, fail international fair trial standards, including the perception of impartiality of the courts. The WGAD also concluded that the deprivation of liberty appears to be in retaliation to Mr. Donziger's work as a legal representative of indigenous communities in Ecuador, that he should be freed immediately, and that he is due compensation for these violations." Now, I will link you to the full statement down below in case you want to read the whole thing, but they then go on to call out Joe Biden, and they call him out by name, and they specifically say that he needs to prove himself if he's serious about climate change. They say, "The Biden administration must send a clear signal that it stands with communities harmed by pollution and environmental destruction and the lawyers courageous enough to represent them and not the corporations that benefit from polluting water, air, and land of local people." And finally, they go on to say, "When the UN and international environmental and human rights communities repeatedly call for immediate action, the Biden administration must not remain silent." Now, the letter has been signed by Barbara Lee, Cory Bush, Jamal Bowman, Ayanna Pressley, Ilhan Omar, Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, Rashida Tlaib, Jesus Chuy Garcia, and Raul Grijalva. Now, many of you already know the details about the Stephen Donziger case, but it's worth revisiting since we're talking about it, because this is truly outrageous, and every single person who cares about climate change has to be concerned with this, because if Chevron is allowed to get away with this, again, it's going to happen to more people, and this is something that Stephen Donziger emphasizes as well. So I want to share a really quick clip from Democracy Now! This is just kind of a concise overview of the situation.
"We turn now to what's been described as the Amazon's Chernobyl. 1,700 square miles of land in the Ecuadorian Amazon, devastated by decades of reckless oil drilling. 10 years ago, Ecuador's Supreme Court ordered Chevron to pay $18 billion for dumping over 70 billion liters of oil and toxic waste into the Amazon. The ruling came in a lawsuit brought on behalf of 30,000 Amazonian indigenous people who'd been suffering since the mid-60s, when Texaco began drilling on their ancestral land. Chevron bought Texaco in 2000. The landmark ruling was seen as a major victory for the environment and corporate accountability. But Chevron refused to pay or clean up the land. Instead of cleaning up the Ecuadorian Amazon, Chevron has spent the past decade waging an unprecedented legal battle to avoid paying for the environmental damage, while also trying to take down the environmental lawyer Stephen Danziger, who helped bring the landmark case. With the help of dozens of law firms, Chevron has ended Danziger's legal career. He's been disbarred. His bank accounts have been frozen. He's been forced to surrender his passport. Steve Danziger has also been under house arrest for nearly 600 days after a federal judge drafted a criminal complaint charges against him for refusing to turn over his cell phone and computer. In an unusual legal twist, the judge appointed a private law firm with ties to Chevron to prosecute Danziger after federal prosecutors declined to bring charges.
So I think it's obvious what's happening. They are retaliating against him. And the way that they're doing that is harassing him by weaponizing the legal system. It's truly egregious. But I mean, if you have enough resources and power, you can do just that. You can ruin someone's life. And because he held them accountable, they don't like that. They refuse to pay, and now they're out for blood. Now they want him jailed. Now, unfortunately, they won because he was found guilty of contempt of court over the summer, and he reported for prison in late October. But before he reported for prison, he said something really important in an interview with Status Quo, and I wanted to share that with you.
What's happening to me is a new fossil fuel industry playbook designed to consolidate the power of this planet-destroying industry over anyone who wants to hold it accountable. Lawyers, advocates, defenders, activists. You see this trend all over our country. It's using the law as a weapon to intimidate people into silence, to stop dissent, and when it doesn't work, to actually put people in jail and lock them up when they don't obey what the corporations, the fossil fuel industry, really wants. So our politicians, our electeds, need to stop this trend. They need to pass laws to protect free speech, and they need to prevent the use of civil RICO, the racketeering law, against lawyers and activists who do this important frontline work to save the planet. Our legal system is so controlled by corporate power right now. It's gotten worse and worse ever since the inception of this case 28 years ago. I've seen it with my own eyes. I've experienced it. And it's a damn outrage that the United States of America, a lawyer, a successful human rights lawyer like myself, ends up 2 years locked up in his home with an ankle bracelet just because Chevron is able to control a pocket of the New York judiciary through these two judges. It's a damn outrage. And I'm demanding to be released immediately.
And President Biden talks a big game about human rights, freedom of, First Amendment, those kind of things. I haven't heard a damn thing from President Biden or anybody in his administration on your basic imprisonment.
Yeah, this is a major test for the Biden administration. They are letting, they purport to support climate issues, the Green New Deal. Okay, you cannot support climate issues to save the planet and let lawyers in your own country who do the frontline work get locked up like this. Okay, the Justice Department, the Biden Justice Department, Merrick Garland, they need to step in and take this prosecution back from the private Chevron law firm. I am being prosecuted by a Chevron law firm criminally. They've deprived me of my liberty. I'm the only person ever in America deprived of his or her liberty on a misdemeanor prior to trial. And it's been almost 2 years. Maximum sentence prior to me is 90 days of home confinement. So Biden needs to step up. Like, this has to become a major issue for the Biden administration, and we need more and more people to speak out.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
And he is absolutely right. This is a test for the Biden administration. This is a test for Democrats in general. And thus far, they're failing miserably. So it's not too late. They can actually show us that they're somewhat serious about climate change by pardoning Stephen Danziger, doing everything in their power to release him. Because what is happening to him is totally inexcusable. And more importantly, if it happens to him, it's going to happen to anyone else. I mean, Greenpeace has been sued by, I believe, Chevron, if not some other fossil fuel giant. Other indigenous activists who are fighting against Line 3, they're going to be the targets. If you allow this type of behavior, if you excuse it, then it's going to continue. So unless the Biden administration puts its foot down and rights this wrong, this is going to happen. And a lot of people are going to be disincentivized in speaking out and fighting against these fossil fuel giants, which is necessary if we want to have a habitable planet for future generations. So, I mean, the case is egregious, but it's really encouraging to see members of Congress speak up. I wish it was more than nine. I mean, honestly, there's a lot more lawmakers who should, in theory, be supporting this joint resolution. And perhaps by the time that you see this video, more will have signed on. But I mean, Ro Khanna, Pramila Jayapal, Katie Porter, there's a lot others who should be supporting this, who should be co-signing this joint statement. But for now, it's nice to see members of the squad and other leftist lawmakers get the ball rolling, because this is incredibly important.